Good morning, Saugus. I'm James Vail, and today is Monday, May 16th, 2022.
And I'm Wesley Cunningham. This is SNN. To celebrate Jewish American Heritage Month, we thought we'd introduce you to Jeff Goldblum.
Jeffrey Lynn Goldblum was born in West Homestead, Pennsylvania, on October 22, 1952. When he was 17, he moved to New York City to become an actor.
He initially pursued a stage career, attaining a breakthrough role in the Broadway production of Two Gentlemen of Verona. Goldblum soon transitioned to film and television, landing small roles in Death Wish, Columbo, A Case of Immunity, and the best comedy ever, Annie Hall.
What a picture. His career would later see much more significant roles in a variety of the movies, including The Fly, The Tall Guys, Into the Night, and of course, Jurassic Park, which became perhaps his most defining film.
Over the course of his career, Goldblum has appeared in 77 films, with another three soon to be released. Please stand for the flag salute.
Please stand, put your right hand over your heart. Ready, begin. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. You may now be seated.
The Serenity Space will be closed tomorrow until next Tuesday, May 24th, during lunch, brunch, and lunch. Students can still request the Serenity Space by filling out the Google form if they need it.
Academic Decathlon is recruiting new members. Their theme next year will be the American Revolution and Building of the Nation. If you are interested, go to their informal lunch meeting with pizza this Thursday in room Q1710.
All seniors! Senior Luau will be on Tuesday, May 24th at 4 p.m. Tickets are being sold for $20 in the ASB office. Tickets cannot be purchased at the door, so make sure to buy them in advance. However, if you bought a senior pack at the beginning of the year, the luau is included.
Now let's go to Diego Takishito with this week's ASB Minute.
Thanks, guys. Good morning, Saugus. I'm Diego Takishito with today's Saugus Sports Update. Registration for summer sports camps are open. For more information, go to the Saugus website under the Athletics tab. You can purchase them online on the online ASB store. Registration closes on June 10th. The Defiant Intermule 5-on-5 Patches O'Callaghan Dodgeball Tournament continues today in the gym at lunch. Don't forget to dodge, dip, dive, duck, duck, and dodge. That's all for me. Now let's go to our very own, let's go back to our acres.
Thanks, Spock.
Congratulations on your win.
There is a mandatory meeting in the gym at lunch for anyone scheduled or interested in taking AP World History next school year. You will be given a description of the course as well as the optional summer assignment.
If you are signed up to take AP Environmental Science next year, talk to your current science teacher for more information on the SEV Water Workshop Summer Assignment. If you have questions, see Ms. Schertz in room X2411 or email her at kschertz@heartdistrict.org.
That's all for today. I'm James Vail. Stay tuned for SNN Radio and Saugus Today.
And I am Wesley Cunningham. Have a great day, and SNN will be back tomorrow.
That's right.
And then you... fault occurs every 68 seconds.
In fact, it's likely that one will occur before this video is over.
And it's not always the stranger danger scenarios that we were taught growing up.
Sure, that happens, but 80% of people already know their abuser.
It's most often someone we know, like a friend, a family member, coworker, or boyfriend or girlfriend.
And it can happen to anyone.
You may not know this, but sexual assault can occur without any physical contact.
If someone has intimate photos of you and threatens to distribute them without your consent, that is called digital sexual assault, and it is a crime.
What you need to know is that it is never your fault, even if you agreed to something early on and changed your mind later.
If you agreed to something before and then fell asleep, that also means no. An unconscious person cannot agree or consent to anything.
We've all heard the phrase no means no, but it's more important to remember that only an enthusiastic yes means yes.
If you've experienced sexual assault and need some guidance, please reach out for help.
Go to RAIN.org. That's RAINN.org.